மகாராஷ்டிராவில் நடந்த விவசாயிகளின் நெடும் பயணத்தில் பெரும்பங்காற்றியவர். அகில இந்திய விவசாய சங்கத்தின் இணைச் செயலாளர். விவசாயத்தை சூறையாடி கார்ப்பரேட்டுகளுக்கு கொடுக்கும் மூன்று வேளாண் சட்டங்களை எதிர்க்கும் இந்திய விவசாயிகளின் முக்கியமான முகமாக தற்போது மாறியிருப்பவர். தோழர் விஜு கிருஷ்ணன் சர்வதேச கவனத்தை ஈர்த்து பாஜக அரசின் கார்ப்பரேட் சார்பை வெட்ட வெளிச்சமாக்கியிருக்கும் இந்திய விவசாய வர்க்கத்தின் போராட்டத்தை பற்றி பேசுகிறார்.
How is the All India Kisan Sangharsh Coordination Committee formed? What are the key factors that influence the formulation of the committee?
See, in 2014 December, the Narendra Modi-led BJP government came with the Land Acquisition Ordinance. We first formed an issue-based unity around the issue of land and forest rights and against indiscriminate land grab for corporate profiteering. That brought around 300 plus organizations of farmers, agriculture workers, Adivasis, Dalit, fishing community and civil society groups together. Later, after the note ban, the demonetization decision, many struggles were going on demanding remunerative price for farmers' produce and also freedom from indebtedness. It is in this situation that you found in Mandsaur, six farmers were shot dead by the BJP government for demanding proper price for their crops. After that, we have formed the All India Kisan Sangharsh Coordination Committee on two issues. That is, it's another issue-based unity for remunerative price for the farmers' crops at least C2 plus 50, that is at least 50% more than the cost of production, and freedom from indebtedness. This is how more than 250 organizations came together. They may have differences among themselves, but on these two issues, we united, and in the course of struggles, on more issues, consensus was built.
What is the role of our All India Kisan Sabha in the formulation of this committee?
All India Kisan Sabha, from the very beginning, from the time the Bhumi Adhikar Andolan, the first issue-based unity was formed, we have been active. We have played a role in coordinating with different organizations, bringing them together. And in the All India Kisan Sangharsh Coordination Committee also, our leadership, especially Comrade Hanan Molla, Comrade Ashok Dhavle, Krishna Prasad, myself, we have been involved with all the meetings and decision-making processes from the very beginning. And we have also had an All India level Kisan Mukti Yatra, in which the entire leadership of the Kisan Sabha was participating. We formed state level chapters. In all these aspects, the Kisan Sabha has been actively involved. So it is the All India Kisan Sangharsh Coordination Committee which actually gave the call for the Delhi Chalo. And post this November 26th and 27th, the different organizations in Punjab, Haryana, many others who were till then not part of the All India Kisan Sangharsh Coordination Committee, and different coordination committees of farmers, even other coordination committees like the RKMS, Rashtriya Kisan Mahasangh, and such coordinations also came together to form the Samyukt Kisan Morcha, which is the main coordination body that is leading this present struggle.
How was the continuous sit-in protest organized? How was it world's largest organized protest?
See, originally the call was for a Delhi Chalo for November 26th and 27th. But the adamant attitude of the government, you all saw how the farmers were received by the government, digging big trenches on the national highway, putting shipping containers, huge concrete blocks, using water cannons in the freezing cold, using tear gas and lathi charge. So that is how they have dealt with it. And as the days have gone, people have come more in number. And that has become a long term, it's almost more than 70 days now that the sit-in has gone. Had the government agreed to the proposal that they would come up to Delhi and the government had listened to the farmers, farmers would have gone after 2 days. But the farmers realized with the stand taken by the BJP government, the adamant stand in favor of Adanis and Ambanis of our country, that this is going to be a long drawn struggle. So they came prepared for that. If it is required, we will stay more. And till it is repealed, we will continue the struggle. So that is how from every village farmers have prepared themselves. Firstly, I think the Punjab and Haryana farmers, it is all credit to them to come prepared in this manner.
And how was it world's largest organized protest?
No, it is more than 70 days. Lakhs of people have participated. On an average, people estimate around 3 to 5 lakh people on a regular basis, and many more who are coming. There's a regular flow which is happening. Even despite all the malicious campaign defaming the farmers by the Modi government, still this has been going on. So it is, that is why it is called the long, it is probably the longest such struggle in recent times. And also in terms of the participation, you see the tractor parade. I think at least around Delhi, around 2 lakh tractors must have participated. That would mean at least 10 lakh people participating in that, if you count only the tractors. But also you had many more vehicles. So that makes it one of the biggest protests.
There were also violent incidents reported. What actually happened on the 26th of January at Delhi?
See, repeatedly the government has been trying to send agent provocateurs. We have many times the farmers have held them and handed over to the police. There was also attempt to some people coming with the intention of shooting the leadership of the struggle, but nothing has been done on that. A small section was given free passage up to Red Fort on that day, which was not the agreed plan with the Samyukt Kisan Morcha. The Samyukt Kisan Morcha and all our organizations have followed the route agreed upon with the government. But this section was allowed to go. Now we all know who are behind that, because Deep Sidhu and this another person, Mickey, and others who hoisted the flag on the Red Fort, their links with the BJP are very clear. And this has been a tactic of the fascists everywhere. If you see the Nazi history, when Hitler, his initial years, the Reichstag was burnt and the communists were blamed for that. Even one person was shot dead, supposedly one of the culprits. But it took almost 20 years for the that to be overturned by the courts of Germany. But here, within 2 days, the truth behind this conspiracy came out. Who is behind this? That it is the Sangh Parivar conspiracy, that is very clear after the Republic Day incidents.
What is the current status of this movement that is widespread across the country? How are the IKE's coordination committee leaders handling the various government reactions?
See, it is a movement they have continuously tried to say it is only a Punjab-specific movement. That has totally been broken, because if you see the protests happening everywhere, from Jammu and Kashmir to Kanyakumari, from Gujarat to Tripura and Manipur and Assam, these protests are happening. And that is why we say it is an unprecedented thing. Though it started in June, and it has been going on across in all the states, the media never covered it that way. It is only after the November 26, 27 that media has been covering it that way. The All India Kisan Sangharsh Coordination Committee and its constituents in every state has been reacting to all the positions taken by the government. We have been mobilizing in different states. States, even in states which don't directly, immediately don't get the impact of these acts, even there we have been able to take our message to the farmers and mobilize in big numbers. We have coordinated with the working class organizations. So they have expressed solidarity, not just in terms of issuing some notices, but actively participating shoulder to shoulder with the farmers. This is also a unique thing of this struggle.
How are the IKE's leaders handling the various government reactions?
The government reactions, one is at the level of the policy reactions, that we are all sitting together discussing, arriving at a consensus, and then in the meetings, whenever the negotiations happen, that we are putting across. We are also having press conferences which explain our, but recently there have been these attacks that have gone, especially after the Red Fort incidents. We have been countering that in our own way through social media, through meetings, through pamphlets. Lot of literature has been printed during this time, and through press conferences exposing the role of the BJP government, the kind of barbaric kind of restrictions that they are. Internet is banned, water, electricity is cut, spikes being put in the road, you have barbed wire fencing, concrete walls being made. It is being converted into an open jail and a violation of human rights. So this has been taken to every village. We are saying you make barriers, we will build bridges to every village and we will take our message. Now thousands and thousands are coming forward in these protests.
As farmers have given nationwide calls to ignore huge capitalists like Adani and Ambani, how have we as left movement strengthened the struggle for taking further the class politics in the country?
See, the left has from the very beginning been speaking against the capital, the cronies, capitalist cronies of this government, corporate, whether it is Adanis or Ambanis and others also, from the very beginning. But probably these three acts has sent the message much more effectively. The common farmer of our country, the poor farmer, has understood that these three acts are for profiteering of Adanis and Ambanis. So they have come out in a big way, boycott of Jio SIM, boycott of Reliance Fresh and Adani products. Different Reliance petrol pumps are closed. And even we have had a unique movement where toll-free movement at toll gates. Farmers are sitting at toll gates and ensuring toll-free movements. So these are some unique ways in which, but the left in this very clearly understand this is a struggle where you every section is going to be affected, whether it is the landless agriculture labor, the tenant cultivator, small farmer, middle farmer. We have tried to unite all these sections, and in line with our principle of worker peasant unity, we have been having coordination with different workers organizations, the central trade unions, and that way we have been taking up not just our issues but also the working class issues.
How this protest impacted Indian masses? Are you receiving support from the working class unions and other classes?
We have been getting support from the working class from the very beginning. And this is a coordination which has we have never seen before. This kind of a coordination between farmers organizations and the working class organizations. The Central Trade Union has expressed solidarity and taken part in all our protests. Actively taking part, and their call for the November 26th general strike, that was also a coordinated decision. So on the same day, the farmers organizations gave call for Gramin Bharat Hartal. So more than the 26 crore workers who took part, thousands and thousands of farmers and agriculture workers were also part of that. So these working class organizations have been with us in our struggle. Women's organizations, student organizations, youth organizations, Adivasi Dalit organizations, they have all been coming in this. So it's a broad based from a farmers movement, it has actually taken the shape of a people's movement.
Are these protests just a call to revoke these farm bills, or does this widespread resistance signify deeper issues faced by agrarian population?
See, the issue based unity is around the demand for repeal of the farm laws and also for ensuring minimum support price according to Swaminathan Commission recommendation, at least 50% more than the cost of production. Also withdrawal of the amendments to the Electricity Act. These issues remain, but even if these are addressed, does it mean the agrarian crisis is going to go? The neoliberal policies have led to this situation where more than 4 lakh farmers have committed suicide. So those conditions still continue, whether it is a BJP ruled government or even when the Congress has ruled, these policies have continued. So we need to broaden this unity to try and take up those issues and work for alternative agricultural policies, work for broadening this unity to other sections which are oppressed, the working class and the oppressed castes of our country. And then try to build a unity around a set of alternatives, a pro-people alternative. I think that is the direction in which this movement will take its, will go in that direction.
As Joint Secretary of AIKS and a representative of the Coordination Committee, what would you say to the Indian population?
To the Indian population, the people of our country, I would say we have got a lot of support already from the people of our country. But this struggle is not just for the farmers. It is a struggle for all of you. And it is a struggle to safeguard the food security of our country, to safeguard agriculture from corporate takeover. So it is a fight that all of you should be part of. So while you are expressing solidarity, sitting in your own homes or in your villages or towns, it is also required that you come out on streets in active solidarity with this struggle.